Double dumbbells today, mate.
What double dumbbells?
What?
I've got what double dumbbells?
Oh, have you got a kettlebell and a dumbbell? It's roughly the same.
I use the other one.
I've got like a 17 dumbbell and a 20 kettlebell.
Yeah, do that. Then just do for six rounds. So do like one round to
switch them.
And then both the arms, yeah.
Okay.
Okie dokie, we got 10 on me. Right, less fast than what we're doing, right? We all on mute. Okay, team. Right, cool.
Okay, team. So the actual workout is 6 rounds, 12 dumbbell cleans, 12 shoulder to overhead, and 24 mountain climbers. Okay? So let's just go through the movement standards of that, then we'll do our warm-up, okay? So for your dumbbell clean, really, if you've got 2 dumbbells or 2 kettlebells, it would be great to work with double today. If you only have one, that's fine. If you are working with 2, the dumbbells start on the floor for your dumbbell clean, touch the ground, and make sure that your back is flat in your deadlift position. Stand up and use a hip drive to fire the elbows through, and the dumbbells finish on the shoulders. Note that the power comes from the hips, not from the biceps, okay? So there's your dumbbell cleans. Now your options for this is, if you wanted, you could go from the hand, okay? So whether you use 2 or 1, going from the hand is just going from the knee. So you don't have to touch the floor. If you do have a few little back niggles or issues, or you're really tight in your hamstrings and your back, and you want to go from the hang today, that's totally acceptable. If you're using 1, pass back through the knees, use your hips, drive the elbow forward. This would be a hang clean. And if you're using a kettlebell, just make sure that when you drive up, palm faces in and then out. Okay, so that you have a little rotation, and it just means that the kettlebell doesn't slap you on the back of the wrist. If you get stuck, watch John, because he's much better on kettlebells than us. Okay, so dumbbell clean or kettlebell clean. If you've got 2, use 2. If you've got 1, use 1. If you've got a barbell, use a barbell. Any questions on that movement? Nope. So just to the shoulder. Okay, and the next one is shoulder to overhead. So the dumbbells or kettlebells will start on your shoulders. You can either strict press. Just make sure your abs stay engaged and your body stays upright. Or you can push press. Dip, push, together. Dip, push, together. Now the momentum comes from your hips again here, okay? So dip and really drive the body weight up to lock out your arms. Your arms should be close to your ears. I can't do it because I'm stiff, but that. Okay? You could do push jerk if you're familiar with it. If you're not, maybe not the best time when we can't officially see you quite close up, okay? So you're gonna do 12 dumbbell cleans, 12 shoulder to overhead, and then 24 mountain climbers. Plank position, we want your knee to touch your elbow every time. 1, 2, 3, 4. Try and get your knee and your elbow to make contact. Any questions on the 3 movements? That's it. Very simple, and it's 6 rounds. We'll give you a 16-minute clock to get it complete. Quite a fast one. Yeah? Okay. So, we will do a few of those in a minute, but let's get a warm-up first. For our warm-up, we're going to go 2 rounds of 8 Samson stretch, lunge and stretch. If you did yesterday's workout, as soon as you sit down in one of these, you're going to be like, oh, yeah, best stretch. So, 8 Samson stretch into 4 walkout lunge twists. Walk out, lunge, chest, twist towards me, and then 8 Cossacks. So eight something, eight walkout lunge twists, eight Cossacks. Oh, sorry, four walkout lunge twists, eight Cossacks. Do two rounds. Then we'll do two rounds of six deadlift. Six push-ups on your knees or full, just a warm-up, so do whatever feels comfy, and then six sit-ups. Sam will do the warm-up with you anyway, so if you get lost, follow along. Happy days? Okay, let's get ready for the warm-up. Eight Samson, four walkout lunge twists, eight Cossacks. When you're ready, let's go.
My cat's just caught its first mouse.
Wow.
I just need to go and get rid of it. Hang on.
Never a dull day.
I know.
Yeah. Oh, you feel it on your hands, don't you?
It's got a bigger one. It's different than that one.
What put the TV on you?
If. See it on that screen there. Because it's been
airplayed. Just fit right up your hands, Bob.
Good job, guys. So you'll be doing your two rounds. Sam's on the second round of walkout lunge twist. Then into six deadlifts, six push-ups, and six sit-ups for two rounds.
Hand it over the foot, as you say, just foot. Yeah, hand up.
Good job, guys.
You know,
What was the second thing again?
Six dead, six oh, yeah. And six sit-ups.
Okay.
Good job, guys. And if you finish your warm-up, just spend a minute or two going over the movements. Make sure you feel like you're moving okay. And if you want to change anything out, if one of the movements doesn't feel right, just give us a shout and we'll give you an alternative. Izzy, what are you watching? Football?
No, we've put a screen mirror on, so we're watching.
Me! It's my face! Got it.
So, I totally missed the warm-up, wasn't sure what I've got to be doing, because I can't see, I can never see the board. I can never see that board.
Yeah, fair enough. Yeah, can your fingers okay, no?
Oh yeah, there we go.
Right. I could.
Dumbbell cleans.
Dumbbell cleans, shoulder to overhead, and mountain climbers.
Right, fine. I'll just call me.
Okay.
This here, look.
If that's any better.
Fair enough. Yeah.
Up here.
That's useless.
It's useless. Where your phone was is fine. Now I know you're looking that way. It's all good. We don't need to make like eye contact or that.
Sorry about that, James.
Okay, guys. So what we're gonna do is spend a minute or two doing a couple of your dumbbell cleans. Remember, floor to shoulder. Just do one or two. Decide if you're using one or two weights. Then do a couple of your shoulder to overhead. And then try a couple mountain climbers. And we will start in 2 minutes. If you need anything, just or want to talk about anything, just give us a wee shout.
Can I get another demo of the knee to shoulder one? For today, so rather than
so the hand clean,
two dumbbells.
Okay, so what you'll do is you'll have your dumbbells here and just go between the knees here
with the two of them, or just go for to one. Okay,
I'm just too stiff to pick up two dumbbells at one go right now. You just turned your video off, babe. I'll put you on mute. You just flick your camera back on. Bingo. Okay, team. Does everyone feel okay with what they're doing?
Yeah.
Six rounds. Why is he not sure? Six
rounds.
Sam's going to do the whole workout anyway. So maybe just watch him for a wee minute. Just remember, it's 12 reps of clean. 12 above your head and 24 mountain climbers.
Yeah.
Universal sign for mountain climbers. So if we do have to just resort to sign language, it's... Okay, good team. Right, I'll put your 16-minute clock on.
I don't stand on my hands while I'm not working.
10 seconds. Are we team? Let's do it. Let's go. Good job, guys. Remember to bend your knees a little bit at the bottom. You're keeping a super flat back. Doesn't have to be leaning forward. You can dip a little. Good. And shoulder to overhead. Keep those abs tight. Good job, team. Then mountain climbers, 24 of them. Your knee needs to touch your elbow. Well done, team. Then start again. Let's get these biceps on. Good job, Jimbo. Keep moving, bud. Wisey, if you want, you could just do deadlifts or just curl. Just curl your weights if your back's not playing ball.
He's Spartan.
What?
He's Spartan.
Is he actually?
Thinking. Probably a dog.
So it's putting you off your workout?
Yeah.
Good job, Evie. Good work, Sammy. Good job, John. Absolute kettlebell master. Good job, Kat. Keep that elbow up a little bit higher so it lands like this. Yeah. And then it won't just blow your bicep off. Good job, Claire. Little bend of those knees at the bottom. Get it. Yes, Kat. Nice work, Kat. So you're doing dumbbell snatch just now. So yeah, if it's dumbbell clean, it just goes to here, and then it's just flat afterwards. Yeah? Got it. Nice work, Rosh. Looks good. Let's go, Billy. They're not going to lift themselves, sunshine. Good work. Oh, what? Yeah. Nice work, Mel. Good job, guys. On the clean, let's bring that elbow up nice and high. Good job. Nice work, Jimbo. Straight in. Come on. Sit. Well done, team.
You start in round five.
Sammy's on round five. Good job, Greg. Odd objects. I love it.
It's six rounds.
You absolutely trash it. Smash through it, have you? Seems so. Well done. Good. Nice work, team.
Push.
Oh, go on, Ben. Not done. Oh, you are done. You are done. Okay. Let's go, Greg. Good job, Jimbo. Don't finish, bud. Well done, friends. Absolutely ripped through that. She was done in about 7 minutes.
I think my dumbbell's too light.
Nah. You're an absolute machine, Evie. Yeah. Well done, guys. That looked really good. How do you feel? Pumped?
That's hard.
Couple of tickets.
Tickets.
Juggling, do different things.
Well, some of the programs are written for balance trainings, particularly for Marcus Philly. He always uses two different size objects because, and then like obviously works them equally on each side. Yeah. But it makes you control your core and your coordination and stuff. So it's a really beneficial thing to do, actually.
I tell myself trying to keep more stable, like.
Legit, yeah.
Having that imbalance.
Yeah. And I found more weight, so it was about the same weight.
Yeah.
So it's fine, but.
My weight was a bit light, but I was too scared to use a kettlebell, and then I tried it at the end, and I was like, I should have just used that.
That's okay, now you know. Next time, if you clean some shoulders overhead, you're strong enough to go with a kettlebell.
Yeah, because that other one was a bit light, so.
Yeah, that's, sometimes in workouts, it's about learning what you're actually capable of, and being like, oh, I feel fine. I'll go a lot heavier next time. But over the period of time, you learn more about your abilities and what weights you're comfortable with. So.
Yeah.
I love that, that's spicy. Like.
Stretching out your posterior delts, lol. Your triceps. Your chest. Your back and side body. Just give yourself a few minutes to just stretch your shoulders off so that you can touch your own face later.
What do you mean, did you get hammies, Greg?
Hammies on fire, man. Go for a run again today as well. Fucking hell, man.
Are you actually going to wee run?
Yeah.
Any rest days are you giving yourself a week?
What is it?
Any rest days are you giving yourself?
Just one.
If you feel that,
maybe like take two,
I've been doing like double sessions every day, we'd have two, but sometimes you're just doing like a run, one run a day and then two zooms the next day and then, you know what I mean?
I'm saying like you as well,
go on, feel. Yeah, like I'm taking an extra rest day today because I'm kind of burst.
I was just going to do you still have a set day or do you just rest when you feel like you need to rest?
I do have a set day if I'm on a set program, like if I'm working up towards something. And even if I feel tired, my coach knows I feel tired. He's programmed accordingly. Like,
to make you tired.
The worst day of my life when he knows I'm tired. It simulates comp, but like you're going to be knackered and have to perform your best. So
yeah.
But other times, like right now, it's a little bit more relaxed. If I feel absolutely pooped, I'm going to eat a chocolate crispy cake for breakfast and take a rest day.
Yeah, yeah.
So far, I'm on track.
Yeah.
Like a set routine.
Yeah.
You wake up and you're like, nope, not today.
Yeah.
The hard thing is, see when you begin fitness, like, and I don't mean begin as in the first week, like, technically in the first 2 to 3 years of your fitness journey, going from one type to the other, you're considered a beginner. So yeah. In the first year, you're so keen, you just go, oh, I'm going to go all in. And it's so easy to go on CrossFit because there's so many skills, handstand push-ups, toes to bar,
handstand
walks, kettlebell complex, clean, jerk, snatch, deadlift, squat. There's so many variations that you don't want to fall behind, and it's almost like you want to catch up with everyone else.
Yeah, you feel like you can't take a day off because there's not much to do.
Exactly. So you almost feel like if you're taking a rest day, you're missing out. At the start of my CrossFit journey, the one thing I didn't do was rest, and I did get injured. So I took some time out with a bad knee. So I would suggest, if possible, a rest day or two, you're better with the rest than not enough.
Not enough, yeah.
Yeah. So yeah, good tracks. Hi, Ben. Okay.
Beneficial insight for people.
Hi, Ben Foster. You got a sore foot?
You're still broke?
No, now it looks like it's the other foot.
Yeah, he just stubbed his, and you know when you, he's like bent his big nail back, so it's broken off. Like he's just on it there just now. I don't even know what to do with this boy. So this leg is broken, and now this one's got no big toenail. Still no tears though. I don't know what's wrong with him, but he just doesn't. Yeah.
In a minute, give me 1 minute.
Anyway.
Yes.
Guys.
Welcome.
See you later.
Thank you.